And as you can see, I have a ton of plants, which is a recurring theme here. But I do have this one space that has been opened for a little while. So I figured a shelf, a hanging shelf here, would actually fit quite perfectly. But I haven't been able to find one.
Hey, it's Kenah, and today I'm going to be helping plant expert Summer Rayne find the perfect shelving unit to complete her space. I'm a Nifty producer, which means that I'm constantly buying furniture and decor online. So now I want to share with you all the tips and tricks that I've learned from all of the feats and fails of online shopping, because I have bought a lot. So here's how we're going to do this. I know that online shopping can be super daunting, and it's really hard to find the perfect piece of furniture without seeing it in real life first. But that's right, we're going to figure that all out today. After all the research, I'm going to make a short list of the three best shelves that would fit Summer's room. Third, we're gonna see which piece Summer picked. We'll see what it looks like in real life and whether it really is the perfect piece.
Hey, I'm Summer Rayne, and I'm the host of Plant One On Me on YouTube and also the author of forthcoming book, How to Make a Plant Love You. And you're here in my apartment in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. So I figured a shelf, a hanging shelf here, would actually fit quite perfectly. But I haven't been able to find one, and usually I get my furniture through, you know, on the side of the streets. There used to be a lot of great furniture shops around here, vintage furniture shops, and maybe something that's a little bit rustic and also industrial. So, you know, something like this that has like kind of exposed wood. I mean, obviously no plastic. Plastic doesn't really go in my house. I don't have a lot of plastic in here, but I think, you know, we could work around a specific style just because my house doesn't really have a specific style because I've just picked up furniture from all sorts of places, but I think that's part of what gives it its charm.
Wow, Summer's apartment probably has the most pure air in all of New York City. That is hands down the most plants I've ever seen in a house. So the specifications that she's given us is it needs to be a shelf that can house all of her beautiful plants. It needs to hang on a brick wall, be in a rustic industrial style, not really use much plastic because that's not her thing, and suit the whole theme and vibe of the bedroom. So there's a couple of tips and tricks before we get shopping that you should really take in consideration when buying a shelving unit. First is knowing the exact size of your space. There's nothing as bad as installing a shelving unit and it being too small or too big for your space. You need to know the maximum weight of all the things that are going in your storage unit before you press purchase so you don't end up with a shelf on the floor. Thirdly, pick a style that complements your home. If you're putting a lot of intricate trinkets and details on a shelf, probably go with a more simple style. Or if you've got a whole bunch of basic books or plain, clean looking things, you can go for a more ornate, detailed style or with a big pop of color. So we're gonna start at West Elm and see what they have. Let's start with the search bar shelf. All right, there seems to be a lot of different kinds of shelves, so we're gonna narrow this down. In this case, we're not looking for a freestanding shelf. It needs to hang on the brick wall just because there's already a storage unit on Summer's wall below the shelf. So let's narrow down our search by saying wall shelf. And this first option looks pretty cute, the L-beam wall shelf. And it looks big enough to house plants as well. One really important thing to look at when buying shelves online is whether it comes with the mounting hardware. Each wall is completely different, and because Summer does have a brick wall, she's gonna have to use a little bit more industrial plugs and screws. So this does come with mounting hardware, but I feel like she might have to buy some extra stuff on her own, but that's all right. So let's move on. I feel like a really great site for her would be Etsy. You can get some really great handcrafted pieces, which I think is definitely Summer's vibe. I really like the style of a hanging shelf with rope. I didn't really spot any of them in her bedroom, so that could be a cool, like, new quirky addition to the rest of the shelf. So let's say wall hanging shelf and narrow down our options. This is a trio two-toned shelf. So a really handy thing to look out for is its durability for scratching. So ones that are handmade like this, it doesn't really say whether it's sealed or not. Sites like Etsy are really good because you can ask the seller directly, but big box stores are really great as well because they're really responsive on social media, on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter. I've got really fast response times when I have questions about furniture. Everybody loves Target, but I feel like it could be a little mainstream for Summer. But there's a couple of lines they've been coming out with smaller pieces that are a little more unique and rustic. This is what I'm talking about. They've got a three-tier industrial pipe wall shelf. And it looks similar to the kind of stuff that people are DIYing on Etsy. Let's move on and we'll look at Urban Outfitters. They usually have a lot of organic, natural looking products. See, this stuff looks super handcrafted, kind of like you bought it from like a local market, but you don't have to go to Morocco to find it. Another tip with picking a shelf that's gonna house plants is you need to know whether the surface can get wet. This is a beautiful piece, but I'm afraid the macrame might get a little bit damp and moldy if she's gonna be spraying it and watering it quite often. One funny thing to think about is if you have cats in your apartment, whether the cat can get up onto the shelf. Like, I feel like this shelf, a cat could definitely grip its claws into. Funnily enough, Summer doesn't have a cat, but she does have a little pet chicken named Kippy. And that's for another video, but we're definitely gonna get Kippy's approval on this shelf. One thing that I like to do when I'm online shopping is just do a random Google search for your product. It's a Russian roulette of what is gonna show up, but often you're gonna find your best products from websites that you've never heard of before. If it's curating your selection by the websites you've already been looking at recently, do an incognito tab on Google and try it again. Sometimes the unlikely websites are where you're gonna find a gold mine for what you're looking for. Summer is definitely not a teen, but it looks like they've got some really good designs. See, here we go, wooden metal display shelves on sale for $89. And it looks like it really covers a lot of her specifications. It's got kind of the dark wood look and the industrial metal. And it's a really cool thing to do with wall shelves is to kind of use it as a gallery wall of scattered shelves, and you can have things on different levels to display different objects. One super important thing when buying furniture is thinking about how long you're staying at your house for, whether you're a renter or a homeowner. So if you're a renter, you're gonna need to find furniture that can move easily. Sometimes a lot of the big box store furniture like IKEA and Target and Walmart, it's not great for packing down and moving in a moving truck. So looking for stuff that has joining brackets with screws rather than nails, and looking for more industrial metal pieces is gonna last you a lot longer. So I'm so excited to have you here to look at the options that we've got. I spent all of yesterday shopping and I'm sure that you're gonna love them.
Oh good, I'm really excited to see what pieces you got.
For our first option, I went onto Etsy because by your specifications, I know that you love homemade and crafted stuff. This piece was super unique and I thought that it would really fit the kind of aesthetic of your room.
Yeah, I mean, I really like the rustic nature of it. I mean, I think I'm a big sucker for like rustic wood. And I also love the rope fittings.
They do also custom make to your order. So if we wanted it to be a little bit bigger, or even I think they can do like a couple of shelves down. Mm-hmm. So that's what I really like about Etsy, is just it's actual people making stuff that's customizable.
Cool, what's next?
So our next option we have is this LB Moore shelf from West Elm. It has the kind of like industrial look that you're going for.
Yeah.
And I know that it can also wipe down clean very easily, which is so important.
Oh, that's nice.
Plants on it.
Yes, yes, for sure. Because that's definitely what I'm going to be doing. Even if I tell you that I'm going to be doing something else, if it's a horizontal space, I'm going to be putting plants on it.
Yes.
Since my like space is just like a mishmash of stuff, it's like an old steel mill, so it still has some of that industrial feel. And you know, again, the rustic kind of farmhouse look, I mean, that definitely merges like both worlds in my house.
Our third option we have is from Urban Outfitters, which a lot of their stuff is like more eclectic, probably a little bit more imported than handmade, but this is like a rattan bamboo shelf. I was thinking it would look really awesome if you had like two or three of them stacked down.
I do like that kind of like natural feel. The fact that it is rattan and bamboo, I think, like, you know, gives a lot of that natural feel that I already have like going on in my home.
Totally. And I feel like because you do have a lot of different woods, you kind of could mix something in a little bit lighter and it wouldn't be like a huge standout. So you've had some time to look over the options and I think you've been vibing with most of them. So do you think you've come to a decision?
I think I definitely have. I know one that I think would look perfect for my space.
Amazing, I'm so excited. We'll see your delivery up now and then we'll see what it looks like in your apartment covered in beautiful plants.
Yeah, great, thank you so much.
It's all good.
Hey guys, so I just got my shelf in from West Elm. It's huge. It's a lot bigger than I expected. So I'm gonna pick it up and I'm gonna carry it back into the other room. Here you go. Let's see if I could open this. Also very good, made in a Fairtrade certified factory, which is an added bonus. All right, so let's see. Let's see if they actually give you tools. Oh, this is great. Okay, so they give you all the screws. These are kind of heavy duty screws. Okay, so this is actually what you do to kind of like screw the screw in or tighten it. And oh, this is perfect. This is what I was looking for. So this is great for my wall because I have like a crotchety old brick wall. And the way that these work is that you drill a hole in the wall, you put these in, and then once you drill the screw in, it actually expands. It seems
pretty straightforward. There's not many moving parts. So I'm gonna just set these up right now. Okay. Ooh. This is a heavy shelf.
And this says here, maximum total weight capacity for this product is 60 pounds total.
So I can't be putting too many plants on here. Center. So I'm just gonna put a little measuring tape right there. So I just measured it out and we're gonna drill some holes in the wall now. This is not the most ideal drill to be drilling holes in this brick, but just a little tip, I put a little tape on here just because I didn't want to drill the hole too far, because if you drill the hole too far, then your screw is going to go in too far. It really helps to be able to put just a little hole in the wall first. So I'm going to just take this screw into the middle of the hole, just hammer it in slightly.
Okay.
I think that is pretty secure, or as secure as it's going to get. This was a very difficult wall to drill into, but I think this is actually pretty sturdy. I'm not going to put a tremendous amount of weight on it, however. Sometimes when I see something, it's like, I know what I want, and I definitely like the second one that you showed from West Elm that happens to be also on sale. But I just think that industrial like meets rustic vibe really fits, because so much of my stuff I've had to customize for my space because it's a little bit of a wonky space. So I just finished my shelf and placing all the plants on this finalized shelf, and I think it looks great. I tried not to overdo it. You could see that I had to practice so much restraint in putting all of my plants on these shelves, but it could only hold 60 pounds, and I think it actually looks better with a little breathing space.